bottom has a beautiful set of tools here to begin her with her new position as water commissioner. So, and we're thankful for her that she's willing to do this work. Miigwech, Ikanigana.
So I'd like to say Chimigwech to Kitagos Kwe for our honoring our water protectors ceremony this morning. I'd like to say Miigwech to everybody here this morning. We're actually running ahead of the... Okay, I guess if the ladies are still close by, you'd like to get a group picture of them? Yeah, like I was saying, we got a really good turnout for this time of day. I think we've already got quorum, and it's just about by 9:30 we had quorum, which probably is unusual for our assemblies when we're running a few minutes ahead of schedule already getting started. So appreciate everybody this morning. Okay, if they have the ladies just in the center here, we're gonna get a picture. Okay, again, Miigwech for that, and we're going to go to our welcoming and opening remarks. And first, I'd like to call the Chippewas Georgina Island First Nation Chief Donna Big Canoe to give us some welcome and opening remarks this morning.
Miigwech, Gary. So, on behalf of the Chippewas Georgina Island First Nation, I'd like to welcome everyone here today. I think we're on time because if you miss the boat, we're just not going to start if you miss the first two boats that are coming over here. So I'd first like to recognize our sacred items in the room and definitely acknowledge our ladies' drum group. Aren't they wonderful? I'm just so proud of our girls. And I'd like to thank all the leadership for coming today and recognize our Grand Chief, Glenn Hare, and our Deputy Grand Chiefs who are here with us today and working on our behalf to help solve a lot of the problems and issues we deal with on a day-to-day basis with the support that we need when we're jumping into our own problems and the backing we get from the Anishinaabeg Nation. So I see some of my council members here, so I just want to introduce some of my council members, if they can give a wave. I see Council William McHugh at the back there. He was our former chief for many years. And I have Counselor Patricia Bickenew sitting in the back there. She's been on council, I think, since when I was in public school. She's amazing. And we have Counselor Lori Hoig, who is part of our ladies' drum group. And we're missing our one young counselor, Benson Bickenew, today. So he sends his regrets. And I want to apologize for the running out of breakfast. I know our staff cooked for 200 people today. Plus, they cooked tomorrow's breakfast for 200 people. So I didn't think you guys eat a lot, because they cooked for 400 people, and we ran out. So they're going back over to get enough for like 400 people tomorrow. I didn't even eat, so I can't believe how much you guys eat, but that's good. So I look forward to the next couple days working, and I want to thank you again, and I hope you enjoy our beautiful community. Miigwech.
Miigwech, Gimakwe, Donna Bickenew. Next, I'd like to call Grand Council Chief Glenn Hare.
Oh, Miigwech. Ani, gdon makkon nemkena gemak. Miigwech tam. Mama gukmesna, Susan gan sakne get. Miigwech kede go. Manar ge get ge gi koyog, ka de ge. Miigwech. Gema koe. Manar kene nem dabjek. Nad ma goin mande ge gi gema win. Miigwech ge gi no kede go. Sinda monje diang. Ki week me go on gain in the nunga, send up in the sink. Gnard wounds in the edge bike. Nebe, Bokwenda and Siggy's gok. Me genix in the gawam the ming. Kenny me ya, by ya, Mandana keen. Me go on the basic, send the Panegagi and meek munch in the Mandana be. We knock dead man, Panemaba coat towers. We not mag we gagi in the NN man gagi. Keshep kekba, we nak den man we ni sing man da panen be zagan sin dis ko yang etek panen gumba ap ko tagos queen mon et ko nango e ga o kiu ne me go se. Good morning, chiefs, councillors, Anishinaabeg. I understand we have our website on, so to all Anishinaabeg, then makurnem. Good morning. First, I want to say Miigwech to our elder Susan for giving our Thanksgiving. All the water keepers, all the women who are responsible for taking care of the water for us. Miigwech. And to Chief Donna Bickenew, I want to say Miigwech for welcoming us and to your council and to your community. We all know we're so proud when our chance is up to host the nation, and this year's your opportunity, and we're here, and we're all excited, and we must be. We ate everything already, so as long as we don't end up with McDonald's, we're all right. So, Chief, with my opening here to your community, to your citizens, and I know former leaders. I've been with them when we used to come here and talk about the concerns of the water, and that's the York sewage, the problem that you have here. Every table I sit at and that I attend, I always mention what's going on here. And I hope someday the government would hear us and that they would come and see and visit you. And one of the biggest things, or the biggest push I'm really doing for you here on that, and I've heard you before that you want to be at the table when decisions are made. And that's what I'm asking them to, if they should ever, and I hope they come to you, to your community, and invite you to sit and when they're making these decisions, because it affects all. So I just wanted to convey that to you. So Miigwech. Geget, Gimak, Kenogashin de En Ching, Nanguk the Mountain Mission, the Mishkumanawe, Nebe. We quim naden mananga, Nebe, and Nagdenjimot, Mission the Nunga Gina Gam de Ming. Josephine, give me any guns at Chickabay. Mandan be wasage give me ya. Mabadish que zenshinda karnig mang nungo we me odut nungo we nigan zit. Guy in the butch he can see mean Josephine Gamizich get. Kino mot nen. Punish book dick the mail, Miss Gogan Josephine got kidded. Good to go. We have diction we nigan zima den nikia. Midish country, Midish wonder, Mabaganch up nang Adam, is Nakazet. We milled out where we need guns it. We Mabagam me giat nen cook miss nana. Give me giant canagums where he can dance wash it to get Mabba. Midish no question there sticking. Guy get where to go. You get canoe over the button up on it. Was she go ekating, get the stigger me ekating. Guy went to the shock of the same. Meters number Mama and Jamon Jidding Nangoshinda. So, chiefs, counselors, citizens, and guests, welcome to the 2019 Grand Council of the Anishinaabeg Nation. This year, our minds and our hearts are brought together in unity. For the Quibnaden Mana and the Nagdenjik, honoring our water protectors. In our communities, we are proud to have many very committed Quilk who proudly stand for, educate, and advocate for the protection of water in and around our Great Lakes and beyond. The Anishinaabe Nation stands strong with all our water protectors. You do great service to our precious Nibe, Miigwech. This morning, a ceremony, we celebrated and honored the appointment of Autumn to the highly regarded role as the Water Commissioner of the Anishinaabeg Nation. Her dedication to continue the work initiated by Grandmother Josephine is a fine example of youth leading the way. The Anishinaabeg Nation puts our words into action. We just don't talk about our youth. We raise them and support them. Autumn, on behalf of the Anishinaabeg Nation, you need to know that we are very proud of you. Chimigwech, for accepting the commissioner role on our behalf of the nation. Miigwech. So we look forward to you marching with you if you have to, and whatever, we'll walk with you. Miigwech. Minoshka, Niganzing, Gemaawing, Kenomiko Mestigang, Jitchmang Dam no Jiminan, Gwinagden Mang. Wabung, Kwam Dana, Kenanakin, Joshua Gajitigang, Wendigayan Kitagwing. Adrian goes in the Maya, Mimabe Niganzi Tut, Manda debat the Marsh in the Benotiak. Shunyage Kimonjituna, Kimuts, Miga Ida got kidding, Gooding of the Kamnotik Kasnama de Shunya, Mida Sharsgo, Kishitsgame, Kipambochigum, Kinange bike, Win Satamek, and Nick Yangshinda. One and King Yabe. Apchisko, the nom, come nom now the mewabung, sits gang way. Kinnegago mego nab them gutse. We want you to mego, gay go on the getita gate, gange buying, yatin nak yuk. Menashke omna, gino gain mark, mabi atrian, Gabogomna, the tem gutse, when ya we not maga sort on deck, and take a box in the ding, we magabo and kita wing. Chige go away, not when not the madwin. So yet another example of the Anishinaabe Nation leading the way. This week we celebrate the formal launch of the Kinawaswin, the implementation of our Anishinaabe Nation Child Well-Being Law. Many years of work and unwavering dedication from leadership, past and present, and community members who worked tirelessly to strengthen families and communities, had a vision to create our own child well-being law towards our own child well-being system. I am so proud of the work that has been achieved. We saved internally for years to cover the cost of community engagement sessions, to cover the cost of developing our law, and this week we celebrate. We celebrate those communities who wish to implement community-based alternative to the intrusion of external laws that damage our families and communities. The potential is significant. So we will witness that tomorrow. We have a big plans for that tomorrow now, and I hope we can all be here to witness that. So, Mijajung Gobun, Akunagamagong Ganish in the Winnie Gansi, and we pani Ganyman and Dentkeen. Apchuskunimna, Sarsgo, Gago Chicken in the Kisi Kinagago, Batino, Gimakas in the Mudwok, Nashkegi, no, Book Sedman Nimpane, we will not move, Kinamam, good Mudbia. Chicken me ya. After goes Nagaran Gundang, Mandashi will get Maksha Mia, after get Chinandam, get Chishia, Batinia. Gatin go Mia, when that get Maksha the Gardnaka mine, a Kungo Bunkak, Madbosh in the knee when a yachik. Panao Quedeo Gabisna Kesan, Babish Kesan, that was sent Mr. Abish, we sent machine with Matabia, we saw Kidok. Shama Jeeves okay, go on, Gunang, we know he's been good at the upper Zao Code. Come and catch Nipandania, seek Pane, Gago, we sit together. Me questions gained the Nakwe. This path, where am I here? Okay. So, Chiefs, it has been an absolute honor and privilege to represent our great nation as your Grand Council Chief this past year, to support and advocate with you and for you on opportunities and challenges to action Grand Council resolutions that you put forward as our mandate. Miigwech for all your support. I also want to thank the management, the directors, and the staff of the Secretariat for their dedication, extraordinary effort, and hard work in making this organization the most respected PTO in all of Canada. Your expert support in the political office to our chiefs and to our communities is appreciated. We do have the best of the best. This past year, we were tasked with implementing an enhanced political executive, with each region electing your regional Deputy Grand Council Chief and Chair. To respond and support your regional priorities and perspectives, as well as attend their clan functions and portfolios. This new arrangement has been an interesting shift for us all. I must commend Northern Superior Deputy Grand Council Chief Ed Wauye, Southeast Region Deputy Grand Chief James Marsden, Southwest Deputy Grand Chief Joe Miskokman, and Lake Huron Chair Chief Scott McLeod, and of course, Gemma Pelche, for their work in support of the Anishinaabeg Nation, our regions, our communities, and our people, Miigwech. So, Kinagamagazuk Gemak. Na ewapskejik e kungubun gak na sap keni pi gidem na man man nakkin apres kus nagat ma be nakit wud nem da bit chano dug for there's the cause it think I got the right name in dug ke get kus ajro mak me anen shun ya. Abdek si guim sko gabuing. Manda gam se bak hawan wandak et kita guing. Manda sonya se ganjum maka dek. Nim ne se nissen ganak kiat wandak. Abchus kus nagat. Wim mik mangwe. A year ago, at the same time of our election, when I got elected, elections were happening, other elections were happening too, and that's when Doug Ford got in. And since then, I guess we thought he would work with us, I guess, and I haven't had the opportunity to meet with him. We did have an invite in Queen's Park a few weeks ago, but he wasn't there. But we met some of his colleagues, cabinet. But he's starting to affect us now somewhat on his cuts. We have two of them. The AORMC was the biggest hit from our organization. And the Anishinaabe Fisheries Resource Center, 70% of the funding was cut. So as you can all, when we hear that size of a cut, it's really hard for us as leaders, and as your Grand Chief and my colleagues and your CAO here, to address them kind of cuts. Because we might have to let people go. That's the hardest part. Because the work that they've done and these cuts, you know, everything is going good. It was going good. Your communities call upon us. They do their best. So we're dealing with those kind of things right now. So as we move forward here, next couple of days, we have so much things, so much good things, and I share them with you because I support what is coming tomorrow. The Anishinaabe Nation has built a solid reputation on being positive, pursuing our objectives with discipline and focus, and on demonstrating what we do more than just talk the talk. We do not conduct our affairs in the media, rather we are steadfast in pursuit of our objectives in a way that is pragmatic and determined. We have always developed a plan of action based on your mandates. We do this despite encountering challenges and many influences along almost every step of our journey. Government inaction, legislation, policies, and the artist's bureaucratic attitudes impede our intent and our aim to disrupt our vision. We encounter ridicule and criticism from our own people, too, that we aren't doing enough or any progress is viewed as intentionally compromising our right to self-determination. Our interests and relationships with our resources, our inherent and Aboriginal rights, and all issues in between. None of this, of course, is true because the Anishinaabe Nation is a collective of 40 very strong and determined communities who, when we can come together to advance our interests, we are the combination of all that and well intended for the better future of us all. Doing absolutely nothing for continual opposition is doing us more harm than daring to move beyond our status quo. Our shared history stems from the Three Fires Confederacy, which then shifted to the Great Lakes Confederacy. When our traditional forms of government began to ignore and erode, our leaders moved to a structure from form of alliance called the Grand General Indian Council, which in 1949 became the Union of Ontario Indians. Early records indicate that in the mid-1800s, much of the annual gathering discussions focused on the Indian Act, on hunting and fishing, on education, on medical services, and of course, land issues. Our interests then and our interests today are similar, with the same progress, with some progress made in some areas. Chiefs, counselors, citizens, Anishinaabe Nation, with respect to the Indian Act and other federal authorities as it pertains to leadership section, it is time for us to seriously consider a different reality. Our great leaders of the past had a vision and made the following. And the past leadership put this together, and that is the Anishinaabe Nation Declaration, 1980. I don't know who was there in 1980. Maybe some of us are still here, past leaders. But what this paper says, we're all nations. There's 40 of us here. Gallego, Kimigwesina, Ewapskiet. With Ebens get coming going, Yabaginik the Bendanawe, the Mildona and Sigis Gakwe. As nations, we have inherent rights which have never been given up. Kidme, Gdana, Skuziwin, Zinda, Mnashinda. We need Gansing inch buying. Kidme, we should be men. Kesep kikba inch buying. Kaye wapski et yabe. Niwanun meng wabang. Kaye wet kuzunya, nikain kuzwam jigesi me pinun meng wanun meng wabang. Mnash debe benojia mem dige kinishri go en chinge go. Panek dikteme, panek sigishkak dikteme. Begging that kid me when it's gay up again, this per inch buying guy Yabe Wapski had me gay you basic update me as big addiction of the nigga. Nimniching Egan Dan Mandazinag and P. Yamdama Nanome, Midashinda Gantibi Don and Gomanda. We know Mengwe, we am the Meng, Tem Gatuze, Mr. Gadamnamek, Gdana Gosewe. So chiefs, this not a declaration. When I seen this the other day again, and that's why I asked to be put in our binders. This is a reminder. This is what the past chiefs, that's their vision in 1980. Here we are 39 years later. I truly believe that what we're going to hear tomorrow, yes, we're going to hear that dollar figure, but it's not only money. And we are not going and jumping out of the Indian Act. The Indian Act is still there. The fiduciary responsibility of the government, it will always be there. But as I understand this declaration, with the junior that's going to support it tomorrow, hopefully we all accept it to do that just kind of work where we can make our laws. We're there. We can make it. Again, the message that is going to be given to us is, let's get on board, hopefully. We're 17, and I think there's some ready, almost ready. But if we can get 40 on board, then the money that you're going to hear tomorrow to support what we want to do, to create our own laws, we got to get 40 on board. Kishpin, we have known this, but kishpin daptamek nangumanda, kishpin shkego namanatsek nanabun nikcheng. Kagjigoshnim kishpin, we have... We get to it. How we go? Me get no get knocking the gate. Try it. Let's try it. Let's sign on for the next 5 years. If it works, awesome. But if it's not, you can opt out. No penalties. None. But in the kit, the people that put us here are going to vote for this. That's who we're working for. That's why they put us here. I know change is hard. But yes, there's a lot of avenues, a lot of direction already. We're going back to our way. That's still there. But the Jagannath, the way we do some things in 2019, we have to go with some change. So I do ask, it's not only about the money. I've heard it already. It's just, but no, it's not just about money. So I do beg you, us, to try it. See if our community likes it. We don't have no laws at all. I don't have any at home. Thought I did. I thought I had my own, our own election code that was in stone in 96, only to find out it doesn't hold nothing. I was proud of that for nothing for about 15 years. Don't mean nothing today because my chief was absent for a year. She's back here now, but she was out of office. My election code, our custom code, did not hold any weight. So me manda shiguyaming, if we do this and make our own, it's about time. It's about time. So I guess that kind of captures everything that, you know, I'm trying to say in that this declaration. So in closing, real quick here, and again, I think we need to read and let's hold that declaration up for our past leadership. Let's make them proud. We got nothing to lose. We don't have anything anyway. All these years we've been struggling. But we're still able to meet together, smile, love our families, and fight for our children. So with that, again, I say miigwech. I hope we can stay to the whole 3 days. Powwow season is here also. And also the graduations are this time of year. Let's think of our kids that are coming out of school. And believe me, I meet a lot of them. They want to work for our communities, for your communities. They're ready. They're ready to go. We can do a lot if we can follow and accept the work that we're going to hear, that's going to be presented to us. Is that this afternoon, Gary? I keep saying tomorrow. And when? Today, this afternoon. Let's think about our communities. Give them an opportunity and a chance to listen to what he's presented. A lot of work went into it, chiefs, a lot. 39 years of it. And some of our chiefs are not with us anymore. Let's think of them. Jimmy Gretch.
Miigwech, Grand Council Chief Glenn Hare. Just one clarification. We didn't want to get too technical here because I'm not that technical in this stuff, but we do have the, we're being recorded, but unfortunately we couldn't get enough bandwidth. I guess we're told to have it a live webcast, so it is being recorded. It's going to be uploaded each evening, so didn't quite get there. One announcement before we go to our next speaker. There's one vehicle we have to move. It's blocking something. It's a black BMW CEBR892. So if that's your vehicle, they're asking if you could move it. Miigwech. Okay, next I'd like to invite up Southeast Deputy Grand Council, Deputy Grand Chief James Marsden.
Ah, Miigwech, and Hanin Bojo. First, I'd like to acknowledge our sacred bundle, our new staff with the 40 feathers of our communities, the elders, the women, youth, and chiefs and delegates, but also, very importantly, our hardworking staff of our communities that's here, and also of our Anishinaabeg Nation offices. I retired Chief of Alderville First Nation. I was chief there for 15 years, but last year at our assembly, I was honored to take on the responsibility of Deputy Grand Chief for the Southeast region. So I'd like to welcome you all to the Southeast region area this year, and miigwech to my good friend, Chief Donna Big Canoe, and her community of Georgina Island for hosting this year. We've been friends for many, many, many moons, I have to say, and we dealt with a lot of issues as we're facing our one issue here for Georgina Island, but I wish there was some local MPPs here today or MPs and witnessed our water protectors in action as we all stand behind Georgina Island in their fight protecting the waters of Lake Simcoe. The southeast region consists of the Potawatomis of Moose Deer Point, Algonquins of the Pickwocknagon, the Mississauga Nations of Alderville, Curve Lake, Scugog Island, and the Chippewa Nations of Beausoleil, Rama, and of course our host, Georgina Island. But as our Elder Gordon always says, we're all the same family of the Anishinaabeg Nation. And again, just like to welcome you all to the region, and we got some lot of hard work to do, and very interesting issues to go over as we these next 3 days. So I'll keep it at that for now. So, miigwech.
Miigwech, Deputy Grand Chief Marston. Now I'd like to call on Deputy Grand Chief for Southwest, Joe Miss Wolkerman.
Miigwech, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge the medicines and the bundles that we have before us. I'd like to thank Chief Donna Bigknew for being such a gracious host. And obviously, the cooks did a great job because we ate everything up and twice as much as we should have. I'd like to thank the staff at Georgina Island here for their hospitality and their hard work. This is not an easy feat to put on, to have Grand Council in your community with so many people coming in and so much business going on in the community. We could all see it by the number of workers and so on that you have going on in your community progressing. This is the first time I've been in this community for probably over 30 years. And I look around and I look at the ancestry that are around us, the family that are continuing to watch over our work. And I reflect back on some of the older leaders in which I have the opportunity and great pleasure to work with in the past, including Bill McHugh and Les McHugh and others that were a part of, that continue to be a part of this great Anishinaabeg Nation. I want to thank the elders for their presence and their kind words of wisdom and advice that they always provide to us as leaders and giving us another reflection, perhaps, that on our day-to-day work, sometimes we get too focused on the kind of problems that we have today and the solutions that we look for today. But oftentimes, as you all know, as leaders in your community, you rarely get time to stand back and reflect upon the progress that we have made. This organization was founded under the commitment of a message of hope. It wasn't founded because of fear. It was founded in order to move forward as a collective. It doesn't mean to say that we get there all at the same time, but our journey is long. And we come from different points in history, and we come from different times with different relationships. And some are farther ahead than others, but that doesn't mean that we don't wait and help. We come here in a council annually to renew our commitment to one another, that we are all family. We don't come because of fear. We come because of hope. Over the next while, and even currently, if we look around in the past months, we hear many of our brother and sister First Nations across this land oppose this direction, oppose this position, oppose these people. But what are their words? What alternative do they give? we come with a message that we do have an alternative. We have an alternative that maybe all will not endorse, but those that do will move forward and forge new ground, will open new paths, will look for a brighter future, and in turn, I suspect very strongly, they will be there to help us. Do not become distracted. Keep our focus. And our focus has been around seven words: love, truth, respect, wisdom, humility, honesty, and bravery. All of those take hope. All of those take commitment. All of those take dedication and work. And a commitment, while we may not always agree together, we are still family. With that, we must continue to build. We must continue to help each other. We must take from each other's strengths and help those that are weak. We must build together, and more importantly, we will never go back to where we were. If nothing else, history has taught us a lesson, and our lesson is now time that we stand up and be strong and move forward together in unity and as a nation. Miigwech.
Deputy Grand Chief Muskokman. Next, I'd like to invite Ed Wawie, Deputy Grand Chief, Northern Superior Region.
Good morning, everyone. And thank you all for coming to this great assembly. First of all, I'd like to thank Chief Donna Big Canoe for the great reception we have here and looking after us well. And I'm one of the ones that overfilled my plate. And tomorrow I'll take half as much. But on behalf of the Northern Superior, I'd like to welcome everyone here. And regardless of what the Raptors say, we the North, not the Raptors. Yeah. But, I'd like especially to honor the sacred items, our brand new staff that was commissioned this morning. The old one was retired, and we have 40 fetters on the new staff stating that all 40 First Nations are here together. I'd like to especially honor all our chiefs, our new chiefs and old chiefs. I think I was just a young boy when Chief Collins and Chief Shining Turtle started. and they're still here, but everyone were the chiefs and their delegates to the chiefs that couldn't make it. Welcome here to the table. We all have issues that we need to take care of. Some of our issues are very different than others. Like up in the north, we have issues that don't stand out as strong as in the south. We have some resolutions that are going to get passed in the next couple of days. And we need each and every one of our of the First Nations support to make sure that the resolutions don't only get passed, but they get implemented and enacted upon. It's hard to see that some year after year we're renewing the same resolution or repeating resolutions that have been around forever, and we can't continue to do this if we want to move forward. We have to, if we're going to pass these resolutions, we have to make sure that they're acted upon and completed and implemented we bring these resolutions forward because they're needed to get things done in our territories. So, Grand Council Chief didn't leave us too much time to talk, and we still have Scott, Chief Scott, yet to talk. So I'm just going to cut it short and welcome everyone here again, and have a great day. And when you have something to say, get up and say it. Because if you hold it back, it's never going to get out there and never going to get heard and get passed. So have a great day and thank you.
Deputy Grand Chief Wallier, and like to invite Lake Huron Regional Chair, Chief Scott McLeod.
On in. So apparently there's no more food left on the entire island. The cell reception is not present. And the ferry just broke down. So welcome to Survivor Island. This afternoon we're going to break off into regional tribes. And just be thankful it's Survival Island and not Naked and Afraid. Because we'd all be afraid. Very, very afraid. First off, I want to say, I want to acknowledge the sacred items and the drum group from this morning and the elder who spoke to welcome us here. And on behalf of the communities of the Huron region, I want to say Chimigwich to Chief the Canoe for inviting us down to your lovely First Nation. It's been about 20 years since I've been here. I totally forgot how to get here and managed to make it on the ferry. So it was nice to get back here and see your community once again. Over the next couple days, we're going to be presented with some very crucial information regarding the Anishinaabeg agreement and the fiscal offer that was made recently. There's a lot of shininess to the offer. I encourage all communities to scrutinize, to be critical, to ask questions. We have staff and representatives here, Marty's here, to answer those questions. Their job is to make us all feel comfortable and reassured of the direction that we're taking. So please ask those questions and we'll move forward together. That's what we have to do. As Joe eloquently spoke of this morning, you know, we can't go back, we can only move forward. And I think we have some very good, tangible ways that we can get there, and I encourage everybody to take full advantage and review that and ask those questions. So I won't take up any more of your time. Chimigwich for everything, for all the staff and volunteers that are making this possible. Looking forward to spending the next couple days here. Miigwech.
Miigwech, Chief McLeod, for those remarks. That's all the remarks he made and mentioned. Maybe I made a mistake saying we're 10 minutes early when we started this session, but we're still within a couple of minutes of being on time, so I think we're still doing quite well. I've just been notified as well that we have 29 chiefs and proxies registered right now, so we're good for quorum. So at this point, I'd like to introduce our co-chairs for the next couple of days. We have both from Southeast Region, Nora Sawyer, and Roland Minake. So before I turn it over to them and let them do the rest their work for the next few days. I need a motion to accept Nora and, okay, so Gima Pelche, second by Chief Hardy. Any opposition? I see none, so I'm going to turn it over to Nora and to Roland.
Bonjour, the Dodge McQuaid Indigenous Cause, Alderville, Anishinaabeg, and Donjibba. We decided that we were going to introduce ourselves first, but I would like to acknowledge all the items here in front of us. And I'd like to acknowledge our Gordon this morning for a wonderful sunrise ceremony. It was beautiful. It was a lot of people there, and it was wonderful. I also want to acknowledge the women's drum. It's nice to see a women's drum, and they're so strong and beautiful, and I'm so proud of our women. And I also would like to say Jimmy Gwatch to Chief Big Canoe for having us here in the community, and it's been a while since I've been home. And it feels good to be here. And so before I hand it over to Roland, I just wanted to say that a few weeks ago, the regional chief called me up and said, would you want a chair? And I said, a co-chair. And I went, oh, gee, I'll let you know. So I was pondering it and whatever, and then first thing you know, I saw this red car pull into my driveway, and I thought, I thought it was my neighbor. And if I knew it was the regional chief, I would have locked the door because he was coming to bug me. And it is an honor and a privilege to be here today and take this role of co-chairing, and I look forward to the next few days. And I have to apologize if I don't get your name right or whatever. Please, when you come to the mic, just say your name so that it helps me out, because I've been out of the loop for a while. So, Chimigwach.
Honey, Bojo. Roli Meneg Indigenous, Bel Wadam, Kenin Indigenous, Begazed Dodem, Chimnising Dom Jaba. My name is Roly Meneg, and I'm from Christian Island. As a chief of my community for quite a few years, I stepped down 3 years ago. So it feels good to be back, and you welcome me within your circle. I want to acknowledge the medicines that are here, all the sacred items. Acknowledge the women, represent the water. Congratulate the young girl that's taken on that big responsibility. It's a lot of work. I see that you continue to do at this table. And I got this big book yesterday to show us what we have to look after the next couple of days. And it's a lot of work. And I only go to Facebook now to read what's going on in Anishinaabeg Nation. Because it's all there. But there's a lot of things behind the scenes you don't see. And I read a lot of these things last night. Some of the oppositions to what's going on at the class action suit for Indian Day schools. Some of the stuff I haven't seen that's happening here. So it's good to know that there's some lots of work still that we need to do. Again, you know, I've never done this kind of work before, standing up in front of an assembly. So I was asked. Again, I was falling through Facebook on Messenger, because I'm a hard guy to get a hold of. I'm never home. Said I retired 3 years ago, and people ask, what do you do every day? I said, whatever I want. I go where I want, and that's the way my wife and I have been living, spontaneous. Jump up one day, away we go. You know, we ended up in North Bay a couple weeks ago, just go visit a few friends, buy a gift, and drove back home that same day. Since last summer, we've been traveling all over, been to Nashville, went to the East Coast in the fall. We just got back from Dominican there a few months ago. Just, that's what retirement's about, enjoying life, enjoying grandkids. And to me, to be asked to come here was, again, what am I doing? I said, so the past couple of days have been pretty busy for me. I was asked to come here for a pre-meeting yesterday. I had to be here by 9 a.m. So I had to get up 5 in the morning at home in Christian Island, catch the 6:30 ferry, drive all the way here for a half-hour meeting. I said, this is too much like work. Then they get here, said the first ferry comes across at 7 o'clock. We got there 10 to 7 and was already coming this way. Didn't come back to almost 8 o'clock. So got up early for this again this morning. I said, what am I doing? This is just too much like work. It's not what I do anymore. But I will enjoy myself for these next few days. Enjoy seeing all the familiar faces and the powerful words. Powerful words from Chief Joe Muskokomo this morning. That speaks volumes to the work that is being done at this level. A lot of these older faces that I see have been here for a long time. You guys are like bookends. You're holding everybody else up. But you're keeping this train moving. So I hope we have a good few days. I will enjoy myself, and let's have fun. Be witch.
Okay, so we're soon to have a break, but in about 10 minutes, 5 minutes. But before that, we got news that one of our Chief Irene Kell's husband passed away on Saturday. So I'd like to have a moment of silence, if we can, for her and the family and the community. Miigwech, thank you. And all our condolences to the family and the community. So, as Roland mentioned, our role here is to keep the ball rolling. So, first of all, I'm going to review, and I hope everyone has a copy of the agenda in front of them. And my role is to review and accept the agenda. And if there's any additions, please let me know so I can add it to the agenda. So we continued this morning, and this afternoon we're going to have a health break at 10:45. And then at 11 we're going to start the corporate business open meeting with corporate minutes and audited statements. We'll need a motion at that time to open the corporate meeting, and then to close it at the end. We have acceptance of the audited financial statements, appointment of the auditors. And then at 11:30, we're going to have an open meeting, the co-chairs, Anishinaabeg Nation Seventh Generation Charity, corporate minutes and 2018-19 audit financial statements of the charity, and Gary and his committee will be doing that. We also have acceptance of the audited financial statements and appointment of auditors for 2019 and 20, so we'll need a motion to close, open and close that meeting as well. Day two, tomorrow, June 4th, we'll have, am I all mixed up here? I am. Yes, so we're going to have a sunrise ceremony again at 6 a.m. and it'll be on the island, down at the lakefront, beautiful spot. And then we'll be coming back to the community, and I don't know what I'm missing here. So June 4th, that's tomorrow, and then we're going to have Gordon Wobbins is going to do our sunrise ceremony, and then we have a water ceremony by Autumn Pelche, 8 a.m. delegate and guest registration, hot breakfast, 9 a.m. we're going to have the open Thanksgiving again. I'm mixed up here.
Staff for the corporate session. Move into it.
I'm all mixed up, see.
Is it up? Hey, little, sort of
is this the fifth today? Fourth tomorrow?
That's the fifth, yeah. This year.
Yeah. So in the afternoon, we're going to do the Crane Clan. With an Ishtabek Nation Governance Agreement update, and that'll be Grand Council Chief Glenn Hare, Martin Baer, and Patrick Kadabi. And in the afternoon, the Fiscal Agreement update, Restoration of Jurisdiction Operations update. At 2 p.m., we'll have a health break and networking, and then we're gonna have the Chief Circle. That'll be end of today. And June 5th, Sunrise Ceremony, Grand Council Chief, Head Gordon Wobbins will be doing that again, and that's going to be on the island here. Health break, we'll do a recap, Roland and myself. 9:15, we're going to have the Deer Clan, launch of Kauganoswin, and Ogumah Duke Pelche and Adrian Pelche will be doing that. Break at 10:15, Deer Clan Social Development, and this is when the child well-being update, and there'll be quite a discussion on that with Adrian Pelche. She'll be doing a presentation. We'll be then talking about the Canadian Human Rights Tribunal, the Anishinaabeg Nation Children's Commissioner appointment, and the Anishinaabeg Nation Child and Youth Bill of Rights. And then we're moving right into the Bear Clan Health and Healing, and that'll be at 11 a.m. Opioids strategy update, long-term care, Anishinaabeg Dementia Research Project, and Anishinaabeg Health Transformation Update. And then noon, we'll have our lunch, and it's an opportunity for lunch break and networking. In the afternoon, we'll be doing the Fish Clan, addressing environmental assessments, Boreal Caribou Conservation Agreement, Black Sturgeon Dam, and Anishinaabeg Ontario Fisheries Resource Center. Keep in mind there may be resolutions that come along, and we'll be addressing them as we go. At 2 p.m., we have the Education Secretariat update, Anishinaabeg Educational Institute Transitional Strategic Framework, and then a health break at 2:30, Eagle Clan in the afternoon at 2:45, Education Body update and a labor market development update and other business, regional meeting schedule, which will be handled by Gary Dokies, and acknowledgement presentations at that time. Thursday morning, we will be having our sunrise ceremony at Ramada, at the Jackson's Point at that point. And at 6 a.m., 8 a.m., delegate and registration back here, day two recap and day three agenda. Ontario Regional Chief Address, Roseanne Archibald will be here. At 9:45, Martin Clan, Revenue, Finance, Economy, and that's when we'll be talking about the gas and tobacco and the cannabis update. We'll have a health break, and at 10:30, the Martin Clan will be on talking about, continuing the talk about gas and tobacco and the cannabis update. And at 11, we'll be advancing our political relationships. We'll have discussions about Lakehead University, Northern School of Medicine, Aboriginal Sports Circle, Indian Day, school class action, and the federal and provincial processes. We're gonna have lunch. We'll be doing a quick little assembly recap at the end and some closing comments by our Grand Council Chief and closing acknowledgement. And then everybody should be on the road by whatever ferry is after 12:30. So is there any additions to the agenda that anyone would like to make? Yes.
Miigwech, I'd just like to acknowledge Greer Atkinson. She's been trying to arrange a social evening for tonight, which would be at the Boondocks restaurant on the mainland where you catch the ferry. And Guy Beneg is going to be there, Chief McLeod, Chief Henry in the corner, and myself, and anyone who else wants to join in. We're going to have a little jam and open mic session, probably starting about 7 o'clock after a hard day today. Might be a little bit of fun, so there you go. Mark that in.
That's tonight. Was there a hand over here?
Hello, there we go. Just wanted to, if there's an interest out here, to talk about a very important report that came out yesterday. The Murdered and Missing Women launched their report, and maybe a statement from the 40 nations here might benefit the government to act on those recommendations. I think it's just fitting that we take advantage of this time and push the government to do something about these women who have gone through this distress. I'm just thinking if we can add that to the agenda for a topic item, just to support it or push the government of Canada to act on those recommendations. So just an idea, it's up to the assembly, but something I'd like to have discussed. Miigwech.
Okay, so possibly on Wednesday during the social Deer Clan at 10:30 a.m., we could bring that up as an item, and then if there was gonna be a resolution or something, we can get one drafted. Any other, sorry.
Yeah, Chief, good morning, everybody. Chief Shining Turtle from Whitefish River. On the heels of murdered and missing women, there's always commentary about lack of housing, infrastructure, so I'd like to see that, housing and infrastructure, an update on that, as well as education capital. There are bread and butter issues that we deal with in our communities every day, and it's absent here at this assembly, so we should put this on the agenda and find out where we're going. On a national perspective, there's a memorandum to cabinet that's moving forward. Where are we on that? Those are important topics that we need to know about so we can inform our communities whether we're moving on capital or whether we're staying still. Miigwech.
So perhaps we could put that on in the afternoon of the 5th as well under the education portion?
Is that on Wednesday?
The yes. 5th?
I'm only here till tomorrow. So. I've become a big turtle and I have to swim back across. So, Miigwech. And I didn't appreciate being called a bookend. I've been called a lot of funny things in my life. Most recently, Chief Shoeshine, but I'll accept the bookend in the good gracious of the host community, Miigwech.
How did we want to deal with that? Tomorrow morning? Are you here all day, Chief? Tomorrow? We'll squeeze it in tomorrow afternoon. How's that? Bonjour.
Thank you, Madam Chair, Chief Collins from Fort William. I guess I'm just looking for additional information when Polly's up on her labor market study, because as always, I look after her and I raise the voices of our young adults with disabilities, and because we're struggling with adequate funds and resources to employ them in our communities, I think that has to be an open discussion here. Miigwech.
So is that something that can happen on day two of the agenda in the afternoon under labor market development update? Yes, Chief.
Yeah, sorry, I forgot to bring up daycare funding. That's been a thorny issue about the devolution to the Chiefs of Ontario and then to the Union of Ontario Indians, but we should build that discussion in the capital portion as well on the daycare. Thank you.
Daycare, okay. Are there any other additions to the agenda? Yes. I know there is a update in one of our I'll put that on the agenda and we'll try and to see where we can fit that in. Is that okay? If there's, yes, sir.
Chief Shining Turtle, we're discussing opioids. Can we expand that conversation to talk about drugs? And there was, I remember at one time we went to the Union of Ontario Indians and we had there was something called a war on drugs. And I remember in 1980, I was around then, I think it was Ronald Reagan that declared a war on drugs. We don't have language because a lot of our young people are really getting involved in drugs, and we need to think seriously about alternatives to what's going on. Thank you.
So I'll put opioid strategy update at 11 a.m. on Wednesday / drugs, and that'll open up the discussion. Okay. If I see no further agenda items, can I have a mover and a seconder for the to accept the agenda for the next 3 days? Chief Shining Turtle? And Chief Collins? Okay. So, it's time for a health break. 15 minutes. How's that? You can't go anywhere anyway, so. I'll corral everybody back here in 15 minutes. Miigwech.
So.